Consider the Concorde supersonic transport flying at twice the speed of sound at an altitude of 14 kilometers. At a point on the wing, the middle surface temperature is 347 Kelvin. The intermediate layer of air in contact with the wing at that point has the same temperature and is at a pressure of 1.04 times 10 to the fourth Newton meters squared. Calculate the air density at this point. This is one of those tricky questions, because if you read the first sentence and you're rushing because you're in a test, you're going to see, oh, twice the speed of sound. Oh, I see an altitude here. I'm going to go look at my standard atmosphere tables to figure out my values at that height. Then I'm going to maybe try and figure out, do I need to use Bernoulli's to try and take those parameters over to find that point on the wing? But in reality, it's not that hard. Let's just start by writing out the knowns and the unknowns, and you'll notice that it's not as hard as it seems. So the first known, twice the speed of sound. Oh, let me write knowns. So the velocity of the free stream. So the velocity of the free stream is equal to 2 times the speed of sound. The altitude is equal to 14 kilometers. Let's see, the temperature. Now, remember, this is the temperature at the point on the wing. It's not the free stream temperature. So it's going to be 347 Kelvin. Intermediately, and then of course, pressure of 1.04 times 10 to the fourth Newton meters square. Now, a quick note about this temperature. You'll notice that they gave a temperature of the metal surface at a point on the wing. They didn't give the temperature of the air at that same point. However, what they did was they specified that the air in contact has the same temperature. Now, this is actually really nice of them, because sometimes this is one of the things that is hidden or that you have to kind of know when you're working a problem. Sometimes instead of saying same temperature, it might say that the metal on the wing and the air at that point are in thermal equilibrium. It means the same thing. Let's look at our unknowns. For a problem with so much wording, the only unknown that it is asking for is the density at that point. Now, this could be a tricky problem because you're seeing these values here. However, that is actually not needed. These are sort of a red herring. If you notice, we have the pressure of the air at that point, and we have the temperature of the air at that point, and we're looking for the density, right? Pressure, temperature, density. That screams ideal gas law. Pressure equals density times the gas constant times temperature. Now, since the problem up here does not specify whether it is a perfect gas, right, an ideal gas, or whether it's a real gas, so if we just come in here and we'll say assumes perfect gas, I think that's reasonable. Arranging that, of course, algebraically gives us the density is equal to the pressure over the gas constant times temperature. Throwing that over here, putting the values into the equation, we get pressure 1.04 times 10 to the fourth newtons per meter squared. Hey, look at that. That's the correct units. Gas constant is 287 newton meters per kilogram Kelvin. Do you have it memorized yet? And then, of course, the temperature, which is going to be 347 Kelvin. You're going to go ahead and just get the standard unit out, right? Kilograms per cubic meter. So let's go ahead and plug and chug into our calculator. We're going to get an answer of 0.104 kilograms per cubic meter.